Have the fans been waiting for this? The Louisiana Superdome should be a madhouse tonight. The Saints are on a magical ride. What an improbable story for both the Saints and the Philadelphia Eagles, who come in as the hottest team in the NFC. The victor advances to the conference title game next week, and for the loser, their season is over. And welcome, everybody. Dick Stockton, along with Darryl Johnston and Tony Siragusa. You couldn't write a more compelling story. The Saints, displaced from the Superdome as a result of Hurricane Katrina, went from a feel-good story early on to a real good team and captured a division title in the first year of head coach Sean Payton. And how about the Philadelphia Eagles? Very few people gave them a chance to make the playoffs when their star quarterback Donovan McNabb went down. Enter Jeff Garcia, the 36-year-old veteran. He engineered six straight victories, including the wild card triumph last week over the Giants, and here they are. And Darryl, what do the Eagles have to do to make it seven in a row tonight?
Well, the best defense is a good offense, and the Eagles are going to need to sustain drives tonight. And one of the things, they got a matchup with their running backs and tight ends against the linebackers of New Orleans Saints underneath to keep that Saints offense on the sideline. And defensively, they learned an important lesson they played here last time. They started off very conservatively and fell behind 17-3 at halftime. Expect Jim Johnson to bring pressure early.
Now, what do the Saints bring to the dance tonight, and what do you think are the pitfalls for them?
Well, defensively, they've got to find a way to generate turnovers. One of the things the Eagles have done a great job during this winning streak is protecting the ball. They've got to get to Jeff Garcia and force him into some bad decisions and go after the football. And offensively, just keep doing what you've been doing. They've got a very good set of skill players. Sean Payton is a very innovative play caller, and Drew Brees does a great job of spreading the ball around to all of them. And now let's check in with Tony Siragusa down on the field.
Thanks, Darryl. You know, everybody always wants to talk about what the feeling is when you win, but I'm here to tell you what it is when you lose, because I've been there. I've been in the locker room with 50 guys crying their eyes out, wondering what went wrong, looking around at each other. Let me tell you something. Tonight, someone's going to win and someone's going to lose, but the memories from tonight's game is going to stick with these guys for the rest of their lives.
And it's the NFL Divisional Playoffs here on Fox. Eagles and Saints, both of these teams went from last place a year ago to first place in their respective divisions, wound up with 10-6 records. For the Saints and Sean Payton, first round playoff bye for the first time in their 40-year history. His first NFL job with the Eagles, hired by Ray Rhodes as the quarterback coach. And there is Andy Reid, Coach of the Year in 2000 and 2002, and of course Sean Payton, Coach of the Year this year. The Saints, winning the toss, will get the ball. David Akers will kick off, and Michael Lewis to return. And this playoff game is underway, and it's Lewis, a yard in the end zone. Lewis brings it out past the 25 to about the 27-yard line. And here comes Drew Brees. Went from off-season shoulder surgery to his throwing arm to first-team All-Pro, edging out the likes of Peyton Manning and Tom Brady.
I think everything and more. When Sean Payton signed him in free agency, he's a perfect fit. He does a great job of distributing the ball around. And with Sean Payton calling the plays and Drew Brees executing them, this offense has been exciting to watch all season.
Devery Henderson is in the game as the starting wide receiver. Joe Horn is out of there. And on first down, the handoff up the middle to Deuce McAllister. And McAllister, who missed 11 games with a knee surgery last year, went over 1,000 this season and gets 12 yards on the first play. One of the big reasons for the Saints' success, their offensive line. Jeff Fain from the Browns, huge, and the great play of rookie Jarry Evans.
And another reason, one of the best sets of skill players in the NFL. You saw Devery Henderson in there on the start. Terrence Copper is going to see some time tonight. Very deep at the wide receiver position.
Now Reggie Bush lines up as the tailback. Brees swings it out to Bush. The ball is knocked away and an incomplete pass and a crunching hit put on by Sheldon Brown. And Bush takes a while to get up. And now goes down again.
He did not see that hit coming. He was looking back at the ball. That was a blind hit right there.
A great defensive scheme by Jim Johnson because he brought pressure, but he still had Sheldon Brown out in the flat to come and put up a big hit. Reggie Bush was completely exposed.
And maybe an early message by the Philadelphia Eagles defense on the road against the Saints. Timeout. We'll be right back. Reggie Bush taking a big lick by Sheldon Brown now on the sidelines. And so Sheldon Brown leading a physical Philadelphia Eagles defense. You expect a high-scoring game. Both offenses are at the top of the league. So which defense is going to make its mark? That could decide this one. Second down and 10 from the Saints 40. Brees will swing it out to McAllister, and he is tackled for no gain on the play by Jeremiah Trotter.
Well, the defense is really jumping the swing routes. This is Aaron Stecker. He's going to come out and try and clear this. This is Sheldon Brown here. The pressure comes. Drew Brees thinks he's going to be free to get the ball to Reggie Bush in space, but watch Sheldon Brown jump this. That ball floats. Reggie leaves himself exposed and takes a big hit.
Out for one play, and back in the lineup is Reggie Bush, who is second amongst running backs in receptions this year in the NFL. It'll be third down and 10. And in effect, five receivers going out, empty backfield, and the pressure put on Brees with an empty backfield. Jaquay Thomas, who has played outstanding football lately, Brees has to hurry, and fourth down coming up.
Here's the one thing that happens when you play against Jim Johnson, is you're going to see stuff early in the game that you haven't seen on tape. Now the Saints have to get over to the sideline right away and figure out what they're going to do to try and protect some of these blitz packages, because one of their big concerns, well, they were in last on that last play, an empty package, and they got to Brees on that one also.
You saw Reno Mahe back deep and rookie Steve Weatherford with a good punt and a fair catch called by Mahe at the 11-yard line. A 49-yard punt with a lot of hang time. No score. We'll be right back. Back here at the Superdome, and now you'll hear the crowd as the Eagles begin from the 13-yard line. Jeff Garcia has won six straight starts, including the playoffs, a career high for him. Two tight ends, and the first pass is out to Matt Schobel, the backup tight end.
You know, the noise is definitely a factor down here on the field. You got 68,000 people on their feet screaming at the top of their lungs. The Eagles need to go and keep a drive going and not let this crowd get started, because they will be in trouble if they have to deal with them all day screaming like they are.
5-yard pickup on first down. Darrell Buckholder is in the lineup, along with Brian Westbrook on second down and 5. And the handoff to Westbrook, coming off a career-high 141 yards. And a flag is down. Hollis Thomas, the former Eagle, and Mike Carey will explain.
Offense number 67. After the goal, still second down.
That's Jamal Jackson, the center, and that'll back up the Eagles more.
And this is the part of the field where this noise inside the Superdome is going to be the loudest. When you get backed up, it's very difficult coming off of your goal line. The Eagles have got to get some kind of positive plays going to move themselves out of there right now.
So the ball is on the 9-yard line. It'll be second down and long. Garcia in the shotgun swings it out to Brian Westbrook, and Westbrook is knocked out of bounds, maybe picking up enough to get back to the original line of scrimmage. Give him 5 yards on the play. And Charles Grant, the defensive end, who teams up with Will Smith That's been the strength of the Saints defense, their line.
Great pass rushers from the outside right there. Charles Grant, they do a zone blitz scheme. They bring the corner and the linebacker to the defensive right. Charles Grant drops off into coverage. He's one-on-one with Brian Westbrook, but does a good job.
Saints look for a big stop here on third and 10. Garcia stepping up and his pass incomplete. Dante Stallworth, who did not play in the earlier meeting between these teams, but figures to see a lot of action tonight, could not catch up with it. And fourth down coming up, and the Eagles will kick.
That's a matchup that Andy Reid and Marty Morningweg are going to test throughout the evening. Dante Stallworth against Fred Thomas on the outside. This is an offense that lived and died with the big plays early in the season with Donovan McNabb, and they've got to incorporate that back with Jeff Garcia.
Dirk Johnson will punt from the end zone, and there's Reggie Bush. His first touchdown this year was as a punt returner, fields it on his own 49, and will barely get to midfield. Good coverage downfield by the Eagles, and it was Dahani Jones who brought down Reggie Bush. We're back in New Orleans, and the play of the New Orleans Saints this year doing significant help for the spirit of this city. A great boost for the city that was downtrodden after those deadly storms. And this crowd anticipating this game as Deuce McAllister, who picked up 12 yards in his first effort, can't be brought down. What a run by Deuce McAllister, 28 yards into Eagle territory. And finally, Sean Considine, the strong safety, was able to bring him down.
All right, Sean Payton likes to go with the hot hand. I'd start riding Deuce McAllister right now. Gets in behind Mike Carney, that big offensive line. Look at that, Sean Considine. Welcome to divisional round playoffs. Take that. Bam!
He looks sort of like a fullback there, Moose.
I tell you what, you get all this acclaim about Reggie Bush and all these skill players. Don't go to sleep on Deuce McAllister.
Here is Reggie Bush. And Bush gets hit after a gain of 3 yards at the 20 by Jaquay Thomas. And the Saints, with so many weapons this year, starting with Brees, and you've seen a couple of them right now, as they rank right at the top or near the top in all of those categories.
Great depth at wide receiver. They're able to run some open formations, do some different things. Reggie Bush is a wild card, a unique athlete, playing that running back position. But Sean Payton has taken advantage of that. He utilizes all of them in his offensive scheme.
Now McAllister is back in a tailback, and he gets the call, and he gets to the 15-yard line. Mike Carney, the fullback, with a terrific block up front. 4 yards for McAllister. Off to a big start here.
You know, what a big difference between both of these backs. Deuce McAllister, just a downhill runner, lowers his shoulder and goes right north and south. The one thing about Reggie Bush that I don't like, what I've seen so far, is him trying to bounce the ball to the outside. You got to get aggressive and go downhill.
Third down and 3. Trying to get it to Marcus Colston, and once again, the Eagles putting pressure and forcing Drew Brees to get rid of it in a hurry. Normally he does anyway. So it'll be fourth down coming up, and a field goal try upcoming.
Well, they got over to the sideline. I don't know if they got any corrections. Right now, they're still struggling with their pass game a little bit, but Deuce McAllister is the spark. Just don't go away from it. I mean, Sean Payton likes to find out what's working and then stay with it during the course of the game. Just keep riding Deuce McAllister right now.
Not a bad idea. So John Carney is on to attempt a 33-yard field goal. And Carney's kick is good. He won the regular season meeting between these teams with a field goal as time ran out, 27-24. But McAllister leading the way for the Saints. Saints taking a 3-0 lead with 9:24 remaining in the first quarter. Billy Cundiff will kick off. He had been with the Saints this year. They waived him, and then they have brought him back here for the playoffs because of his ability to kick long on kickoffs. There is Reno Mahe, number 34, and Roderick Hood, number 29. So Cundiff with a line drive kick, and the Eagles will start out at the 20 with this possession. The offensive line in conference for New Orleans. They lead 3-0. Patriots lead 3-0, and the Eagles start from the 20-yard line. Their first possession started from the 13th. Brian Westbrook is flanked to the right and now going in motion behind, and the handoff to Karell Buckhalter, and he is knocked back, and it'll be a loss of only 1 yard with the forward progress. Hollis Thomas and Will Smith taking a look at the Eagles offense, and this line started every game this year, and Jamal Jackson, a big help at center for this team.
You talk about the guys are going to try and isolate on the linebackers. Brian Westbrook, obviously, but L.J. Smith, they think L.J. Smith could have a big game tonight if they can get him incorporated early.
Thomas DePay, who suffered a knee injury in practice Wednesday, is in there at fullback and goes in motion. On second down and 11. Here is Garcia going deep, double coverage, and the ball knocked away. Good coverage downfield. Josh Bullock's defending against Dante Stallworth, knocking the ball away. And that time, Darrell, the Saints were right on Stallworth downfield.
Well, they're really going to test that matchup every time they get it. Dante Stallworth on the outside against Fred Thomas. He's got him beat, but Josh Bullock's does a nice job of getting back in the play to make a deflection.
Stallworth, who was acquired in a trade with Mark Cimino, who is the middle linebacker for the Saints, just before the season began. Third down and 11. Pressure on Garcia. Drills it, and the pass caught by Reggie Brown. So Jeff Garcia, with a laser, completes to Reggie Brown, a 20-yard gain up to the 39.
You want to talk about a big league throw. Watch Jeff Garcia on this. Mike McKenzie is going to try to undercut this. Coming in from the right side of the screen, he has very little margin for error on that throw. Somehow he threads it right in there.
Eagles with their first down of the game. Here's Westbrook. Hit immediately by Jay Bellamy, who is starting at strong safety. Omar Stoutmeyer unable to play. A 1 yard gain. Let's take a look at the Saints defense. Played well enough to win, obviously, this year. The strength of this team is in their defensive line. Hollis Thomas returns after a 4-week suspension.
And I don't know what the Eagles see at the linebacker level with the matchups in the passing game underneath, but whatever it is, they haven't really tried to take advantage of it yet. They've been testing this secondary the majority of the first quarter here.
And the Fred Thomas, as you mentioned, the cornerback they think they can do things with, and a fumble. And missing the connection was Garcia with his center, Jamal Jackson. And fortunately for the Eagles, they pick up the ball, and it was Garcia who made the recovery.
Well, there's two things that the Eagles think that this crowd noise isn't going to be a huge factor for them this evening. Number one, they played earlier here this year. All right, throw that out the window, because this place is going to be so loud, it's not even going to compare to that. The one thing I do believe, they went on the road 3 times in December, to Dallas, to New York, to Washington. They've incorporated a silent count without cadence for those road games. They think it's going to pay dividends tonight.
None of them, though, are domes.
Yeah, not like this.
Third down and 11. And Garcia under pressure, and down he goes at the 30. Flags are thrown, two of them, as Scott Shanley, the former Dallas Cowboy, amongst three Saints coming in on Garcia, loss of 8.
Personal foul, major face mask, defense number 91, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
So erase the 8-yard loss. Will Smith called for a face mask here.
Here he comes to the inside on the game. It's just one of those plays that happens during the course of the game. You're reaching out for the quarterback. Your hand gets caught on the face mask. Nothing Will Smith could do. It wasn't intentional. It gets him 15 yards. They should be coming off the field right now. Now, we talk about a game like this with adversity. How are you going to respond to that? That defense should be coming off the field. What do they do now? And Philadelphia on the flip side of that, they just caught a big break. Can they finally get some good field position and get off their own end zone? They're out at the 45 right now.
So instead of a loss of 8, they get 15 on the penalty. First down at the 45. Garcia, the screen to Westbrook. And right now, the Saints have had the answer to Brian Westbrook as Fujita and Simino, the linebackers, limit Westbrook to a pickup of two. We talked about the Saints offense. You can say ditto for the Eagles attack as well. They're 1-2 in the NFL.
Very impressive offenses, and I think one of the big reasons they both have very good sets of skill players. A lot of guys to get that football to on the outside, put it in their hands, see what they can do.
Second down and 8 on the Eagle 47. Here's Westbrook. Tony, I have a question for you. Hollis Thomas, of course, was suspended 4 games for violating the steroid policy by the league. He's missed 4, now coming back. You were a defensive lineman. What does it mean for him?
Well, you know, you get those 4 weeks off, it's tough. You know, you want to work out. Big guys, you know, we think we work out good enough, but staying in shape is a big responsibility, and I think we're going to see later on in this game if Hollis Thomas actually did work out. It looks like he gained a couple extra pounds, but it's only the first quarter, and he's already watering himself down.
Willie Whitehead is in there right now for him. Third down and 3. Eagles in Saint territory for the first time. Garcia decides to run and now overthrows Reggie Brown. Now Brown beat Fred Thomas, who's claiming he was pushed off, and a penalty flag is down around the line of scrimmage. And let's see whether Garcia went over the line before he threw the ball.
Illegal forward pass. Offense number 7. Threw the ball beyond the line of scrimmage. It's a 5-yard penalty. Loss of down. Fourth down.
Jeff Garcia gets scrambled out of the pocket, and sometimes you're just trying to make a play. You see the yellow yard marker, tuck that down and go for it. You can see he's beyond it right there. But you're trying to make a play down the field. I think if Jeff Garcia had that to do over again, he'd have pulled that down and tried to get that first down on his own.
And it looked like he had a pretty good chance of getting there. Fourth down, and Dirk Johnson will be kicking. Michael Lewis is back. Lewis with a fair catch at the 14. And that's where the Saints will take over. 3-0 the score in favor of New Orleans on John Carney's field goal. And a flag thrown back at midfield.
Ineligible member of the kicking team downfield, number 86. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Correction from the end of the kick will add on 5 yards. First down. Timeout.
So Reggie Brown released downfield early. It'll be Saints ball when we return. Cleveland Saints, the magical year started. Sean Payton was hired, and they signed quarterback Drew Brees. They drafted Reggie Bush in the first round, Marcus Colston in the 7th round, and they won their return to New Orleans in a dramatic victory over the Atlanta Falcons, clinched the NFC South, the first round bye. And Sean Payton named Coach of the Year, coming over from the Dallas Cowboys, had only coached in the NFC East till now. And what a tremendous job he did, and kept this team competitive all year and really showed poise even when they trailed in latter stages of games. Now,
you know, Drew Brees is the other piece of that puzzle. I think the main reason Drew Brees is here is because Sean Payton was here. He sat down, they talked, he loved his offensive mind, thought he had a great opportunity here. Sean Payton never questioned his shoulder.
Colston, the outstanding rookie receiver, in motion, play action pass, caught by Mark Campbell, and Campbell, the tight end who has been injured in the last few games, with a 23-yard pickup.
Mark Campbell's a little bit slow getting up. It's the bootleg pass. He comes across. They get flow. There's your intermediate route on the bootleg. Makes the catch, comes in, gets double whammy there. One of the things that Jim Johnson and this defense knew they had to do was defend the bootleg pass. They didn't do a good job right there. The end is upfield. Drew Brees is able to set his feet, and make a good throw downfield to Mark Campbell.
Campbell is up on his own power, missed 2 of the last 3 games with a sprained knee, and here's the finish of the play.
Roderick could get him down low there on the left side, and then here comes Sean Considine over the top.
So Campbell comes out, and already the Saints were thin at Tight end Ernie Conwell, who started the year, was injured in this Eagle game right here in week six. So Billy Miller, number 83, is now the tight end. Deuce McAllister, the running back, first down on the 43 of the Saints. Brees has time, and the pass thrown underneath to Colston and knocked away. Good coverage that time by Dahani Jones.
Well, that's not something you're going to see very often right there. Marcus Colston, you know, one of the great things he does is catch the ball in traffic, on the move, very strong hands at the point of the catch. They got the matchup they wanted, Marcus Colston on Dahani Jones, but he couldn't secure the catch.
Dahani Jones is not going to make a living covering Colston now.
Now Reggie Bush is in the game, and McAllister and Bush have been able to coexist. As McAllister said, his best interest was the same as mine. Bush going in motion to the left. Quick pass to Terrence Coppert. And Coppert hit immediately by Sean Considine and tackled at the 46, picking up three.
The Eagles are doing a really good job of recognizing when it's going to be a three-step drop. We talked about it earlier. We were going to see a lot of this. But their defensive backs are doing a great job of closing on that dump pass to the outside to the running backs.
Sean Considine, he's been everywhere in the field tonight. He's got thrown his body around and hit this base. I don't know if he's going to make it through the first half.
Well, he was installed as a starter after Michael Lewis was burned by Joe Horn in their regular season game. Considine has been there ever since. And right now, both McAllister and Bush are in the backfield. Many personnel packages for the Saints. Brees is pass, and it is caught at midfield, but it'll be short of the first down by about 3 yards. Marcus Colston with the grab, and fourth down, and New Orleans will kick.
But they got a couple of first downs. They had the big play on the bootleg pass to get him out from their end of the field. Now again, they're gonna transition field position back to the Philadelphia Eagles. They could have them backed up again if they cover this punt well. And it's very tough for Philadelphia to come off of their end of the field to start every drive so far in this first quarter.
Weatherford with the kick. Reno Mahe from the 14. Gets by four or five Saints on the coverage and is tackled at the 23 by Terrence Melton. Here's how the Eagles got here. Started the season at 4-1, including a win over Dallas, then dropped four of the next five. Donovan McNabb lost for the season. Then they finished with five in a row with Jeff Garcia, clinched the NFC East, and won the wild card game on David Akers' kick. So they have won six in a row, and Andy Reid's team, which has made four trips in the last 5 years to the NFC Championship game, looking to get there again. As you see, Garcia has struggled when he has played in domes. Eagles first down on the 23. Garcia fires and almost intercepted. In fact, he threw it to two Saint defenders, including Josh Bullocks, the free safety.
Well, there was an opportunity right there for this Saints defense to generate a turnover. They got Jeff Garcia to move in the pocket, forced him to make a bad decision. Moving to his right, throws the ball back into the middle of the field. Very fortunate not to have that ball intercepted.
Garcia has completed 4 of 8 thus far for only 31 yards. And the Eagles line up with four wide receivers. They give it to Brian Westbrook with the defense open. He doesn't get anything as we send it down to Tony.
You know, just watching this Eagles offensive line, John Runyon and William Thomas at the tackle position, they're going to line up, but they're going to have to look down at the ball because of the crowd noise. So for them to do that, they're going to have to cheat up so they can see the ball. Now, when they look down, this defensive end is moving like that. So when he comes back, if he doesn't see him move, he's not going to know where he lines up. He needs to get in front of this guy. That's an advantage that the New Orleans Saints have with this crowd noise.
But to their credit, the Eagles have not had a false start penalty as of yet. With 1:40 remaining in the first quarter, it'll be third down and 9. Garcia drills it and almost picked off by Bullocks. So Josh Bullocks and back-to-back plays with a chance to pick one off. And Dante Stallworth was Garcia's target. So it'll be 3 and out, and Dirk Johnson will come in again to kick.
Jeff Garcia last week, not very efficient at the start of the game. He's not been very efficient this week either. Not a lot of pressure on that one, just bad ball placement. Back shoulder to Hank Basket. Josh Bullock's another opportunity for a turnover. Boy, that one beat him up.
As Garcia told us the other night, he says, hopefully we got our mediocre game out of the way. The punt fielded by Reggie Bush. And he is taken down at the 36-yard line with 1:20. So the teams are feeling each other out here. And we go back to the first meeting of the year. Of course, Donovan McNabb was the quarterback. Dante Stallworth did not play. What do you take from the first game that these teams played?
Well, the one plus for Philadelphia, they got to experience the speed of Reggie Bush firsthand. You watch him on tape, I don't think you have an appreciation for his acceleration, his overall quickness. That is a plus for him. I think the other thing they learned about not playing conservatively, you've seen the beginning of this game, they have brought pressure, they've disrupted the Saints passing game so far.
Saints from the 35 and the pitch to Reggie Bush. Hemmed in, but he can break away. What an exhibition of running. Reggie Bush into Eagle territory. And ends up with 20 yards before Considine catches up with him. And this crowd on his feet.
There's just nothing you can do to defend a guy that has the athletic ability that Reggie Bush has. You can play it perfect. Stay home. Got your spot. All of a sudden, the acceleration that he has to come out the backside and the ability to make people miss in space, and then you get behind your quarterback once you get out on the perimeter.
Drew Brees said he was just an exciting young guy running around early and gradually learned to be an NFL running back. First down, Brees going for Devery. Henderson makes the catch and knocked out of bounds inside the five. Devery Henderson, first-round draft pick from LSU a couple of years ago, 35 yards, and the Saints threaten.
Well, here's the downfield threat for the New Orleans Saints. Devery Henderson, he's their specialist with the speed. What a great throw by Drew Brees. Drops it right in over the top.
And McAllister with the carry. And Deuce McAllister will lose one on that play. Mike Patterson, the defensive tackles, it'll be second down and goal, but time will run out, and that will take care of the first quarter. With the score, the Saints 3 and the Eagles nothing, and this Fox NFC divisional playoff will continue after these messages. Start the second quarter here at the Louisiana Superdome. Dick Stockton along with Darryl Johnson and Tony Siragusa. Saints lead 3-0, but they begin the second quarter with a second and goal from the 5-yard line. They have not lost this year when they were in front after the first quarter. They have outrushed the Eagles 71-6 in the first quarter. Late clock down to one. Brees throw, trying to get it to Marcus Colston and covered by Considine. Third down and goal from the five.
I think they were changing the play at the line of scrimmage right there. Jamal Brown, the left tackle, looked like he didn't get the change. And sometimes in that situation, I think it's just best to just go ahead and line up, run the play that was called. It's second down. You're going to have third down to come back. Philadelphia expected to shift back to the original formation. They were one step ahead in New Orleans right there because of their film study.
Give the ball to Deuce McAllister, right, Moose? I mean, the way he's been running early in this game.
McAllister has gained 43 yards on 4 carries, Goose. He's in there along with Reggie Bush and Aaron Stecker. Reese can't find a target, being chased down, fires, and unable to hold on with Stecker. Looked like he was free on a low throw in the end zone, could not hold on, so it's fourth down. And no decision yet made by Sean Payton.
They get Drew Brees to move. Now he's moving to his left. He's got to throw across his body. A very difficult throw for him. Would have been a heck of a catch by Aaron Stecker, but you got to make those types of catches in the playoffs.
So John Carney will come on to attempt his second field goal. Was successful from 33 yards out in the first quarter. This will be from 23 yards.
Yeah.
Carney gives the Saints a 6-0 lead. Well, tomorrow's NFC divisional game between the Seahawks and the Bears begin at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. Seahawks managed to escape that Dallas game, but what about the Bears? It all seems to be what kind of game will Rex Grossman play, Darrell?
Well, everything is kind of hinged on the performance of Rex Grossman down the stretch, but the Seattle Seahawks, they're starting to get healthy. They've had a lot of adversity throughout the season this year, and you never know. I mean, you've got your defending NFC champions. They've got some good football players there. This is going to be a fun game to watch.
And Alexander and Urlacher, what a great matchup that will be with the supreme running back and the heart of the Chicago Bears defense.
Kind of the same scenario we have here. It's kind of hard to go back to that first meeting and draw any conclusions from that. You saw that Sean Alexander wasn't in that game. Rex Grossman was in the middle of that hot streak he was on early in the season. A lot of things have changed. So kind of the same scenario we have here tonight with Philadelphia and New Orleans, tomorrow with Seattle and Chicago.
Bears won that first meeting 37-6, but that was back in week number 4. That's Roderick Hood, who is back deep, along with Reno Mahe, as Billy Cundiff will kick off. We kind of forecast a high-scoring game, and it still could be that way, but just a couple of field goals to account for the scoring thus far. Here's Roderick Hood, who'll run it out from a yard in the end zone. And brings it out to the 24, where Jeff Garcia will go to work for the Philadelphia Eagles. The Eagles were 5-6. Garcia's first start was a loss to Indianapolis, and then reeled off 5 wins and then the playoff victory. But so far, it's been 3 punts for the Eagles on their first 3 possessions.
Starting this game very similar to how they started the wild card game versus the Giants last week. Had bad field position, let the Giants get out to an early lead. Their defense was able to hold them into that game throughout the first quarter, and then they had that big second quarter offensively.
Darrell Buckholter is the tailback. And Westbrook on the sidelines. First down at the 24. Here is Buckholter, and he is stopped at the 25 after a gain of 1. Jay Bellamy, who was re-signed in week 6. Roman Harper was the original starter at strong safety for the Saints this year. The rookie performed well. He went out. Then Omar Stoutmeyer, the veteran, he got hurt. So Bellamy, good thing they kept him around after he was cut before the season began. Second down and 10. Westbrook back in there. Play fake. Garcia flips it to no one in particular, and a great rush put on by Will Smith and Charles Grant, very nearly getting to Garcia from behind.
Watch LJ Smith right here. They're going to boot out this way. Usually you slam down and then release into the flat. He's blocking. He can't get off. Will Smith right there. Now Jeff Garcia doesn't have anywhere to go with the ball. That gives Charles Grant time to catch him from the backside.
Hey, that Saints defensive line not getting a lot of credit this year. They've given up a lot in the running game. But they put some pressure on Garcia thus far.
They really do. They got Hollis Thomas, a big run stopper inside, but also Brian Young, very quick upfield penetrator.
Third down and 9. Again, Garcia flushed from the pocket, and he has Dante Stallworth wide open. And Stallworth, in a foot race to the end zone, goes in for the touchdown. So they worked on Fred Thomas, as was their plan, and a 75-yard pass to Stallworth, and the Eagles tie the score.
They never got away from it. It's something they felt that they could take advantage of during the course of the game. We've already seen 2 shots down the field when they've gotten this matchup. Fred Thomas has won those, but it's a little double move. Look at the little hesitation. Fred Thomas bites on it. Dante Stallworth is off to the races.
So this capacity throng quieted. And now Akers on to try to give the Eagles their first lead of the game. So the big play is something we haven't seen that much from the Eagles since Garcia has come in, connected there. Philadelphia leading New Orleans 7-6. Early here in the second quarter, the Eagles lead 7-6 on the 75-yard touchdown pass from Garcia to Stallworth. That's the scoring drive, and it's the longest postseason pass in Eagles history. David Akers will kick off, and Michael Lewis stands back for the Saints. Lewis from the five. And it's a drop down at the 22 by Quentin Michael. Tomorrow it'll be the Seahawks and the Bears. The Seahawks, the defending NFC champions, against the Chicago Bears, who had the number one seed and pretty much salted down all season long in the conference.
Well, you've worked to get home field throughout the playoffs in your conference, and for a while there in the NFC, it sure meant a lot. It was at 19-1 at one point there, but we've had three losses in the last 5 years, and two of those three have come while the Bears were at home, so we'll have to wait and see if they can get that jinx off of them.
Starting from the 22, Mark Campbell, who was shaken up, back in at tight end for New Orleans. Brees will throw, has time, and completes it to the 36 to Marcus Colston. And what a great story that is for Marcus Colston, taken on the seventh round out of Hofstra in Hempstead, Long Island. Just four picks from the end of the draft, and as he delivered, got 15 on that play.
Yeah, he was a tight end in college. He came into camp, really wasn't in shape yet, but when he went back after the draft, worked real hard to get himself into shape, so when he came into training camp, he was able to get through those practices and not be winded, and he has been a huge plus for the Saints offense.
Midseason, they were talking about him as offensive rookie of the year. Then he got hurt. First down, McAllister slices off left tackle and crosses the 40, gets to the 44 for 8 yards. Dahani Jones is there.
And don't get away from that. I mean, Deuce McAllister is on a roll right now. He's running behind his pads. A big run early on. He had Sean Considine in the hole and just went right through him. And everybody has talked about the layoff and how will that affect this game. I think the area that you would see it is in the run game. You're talking about a short week for the Eagles and time off for the Saints. That's where we should see if that makes a difference.
Second down and three, McAllister getting close to the first down marker. Omar Gaither, the weak side linebacker who has been a starter in the last six victories, making the tackle, but not before McAllister picks up the first down.
Just a very versatile offense that Sean Payton has here in New Orleans with all those guys on the outside. And then you've got Deuce McAllister, a great changeup with Reggie Bush. We saw the great run in that package. Just so many things that a defense has to worry about before the snap.
Saints already have 81 yards rushing. McAllister tries to give it more, and a superb gain on first down of 5 yards. There is Jari Evans, the right guard, who is on the sidelines right now, in the huddle right now, the rookie from Bloomsburg and born and raised in Philadelphia.
Yeah, he's a big Eagles fan. The first time they played, the team got a ball. They simulated a ball being signed by Donovan McNabb to the biggest Eagle fan in the Saints, and they stuck in his locker all week.
Second down and five. The pitch to Reggie Bush. Not this time. Bush can't escape, and he's dropped by Dahani Jones back at the 45, and a loss of 11 yards for Reggie Bush.
That's all Jeremiah Trotter, though. He's a downhill guy going in to blow up the line of scrimmage. He gets through there. He makes Reggie Bush lose ground, and then that pursuit of the Philadelphia Eagles defense, you got to get a bunch of hats around Reggie Bush. We saw the run, long run earlier. You think you've got him contained, and all of a sudden he escapes. You got to get as many hats as you can to number 25.
And a correction, the loss was only 6, bringing up 3rd and 11. Saints from their 45, and the screen to Reggie Bush. Bush has a blocker in front, and he'll get the first down and scamper out of bounds at the Eagles 40. And it was Jamar Nesbitt, the left guard, who was downfield for the block, and Bush picks up 13.
Oh, what a great play call, because your pressure is going to come in from this side here. They've got the screen out the back door away from where the pressure's coming. Couldn't call one better. Here comes the pressure on the outside. No panic. I got Reggie Bush going out the back door on the screen.
Saints with a first down. They mark it at the 41 of Philadelphia. Here's Colston. Got those solid hands and makes the grab with a defender on his back. Gets 5 yards with the linebacker Omar Gaither, who replaced Matt McCoy. Gaither, the rookie from Tennessee. It was the installation of Gaither and Considine in the defensive unit by Jim Johnson that helped turn the Eagle defense around late in the year.
Well, for Sean Considine, I just think he fits what the Eagles are doing. They're playing more two deep safety. Michael Lewis is a player who likes to come down in the box. Very good down there defending the run. Sean Considine, more of a deep half safety. And then Omar Gaither, he's a rookie, so it just took him a little while to dig into the flow of this defense.
Second and 5. Reggie Bush is dropped. Back at the 41-yard line, a 2-yard loss. Trent Cole coming in to stop Reggie Bush, who has gained 20 yards on 4 carries.
Well, Trent Cole's coming from the top, but, you know, Reggie Bush, you know, we saw him earlier in the year, and it's not really his fault. I'm not going to put that one on Reggie Bush. Mark Campbell's got to get across and get Trent Cole blocked. That play was kind of dead in the water when Reggie got the ball.
In a game like this, we have seen the defenses really take over thus far. The 9th play of the drive upcoming on 3rd and 7. Here's Bush. Reggie Bush should get the first down. Michael brings him down, but not before they move the chains.
Some people question his durability and his toughness. Could he be an every down guy in the NFL? I love the way that Sean Payton has incorporated him into the offense, but I think he's answered any critics tonight. He took that huge hit from Sheldon Brown early in the game, has come back in. He takes another big hit right there from Sean Considine and pops right back up.
7 yards on that last play. First down on the Eagles 30. Now Deuce McAllister in the backfield. Pump fake Brees. And Colston defended by Rod Hood at the 5. Rod Hood starting for Lito Shepherd at cornerback.
And I don't know if it's them trying to go after the replacement of Lito Shepherd or something they saw on film, because it looks as though, you know, we saw some double moves earlier in the game, and you just wonder if they're seeing something on film too, and not just getting a matchup on the outside because of an injury. But we saw how Philadelphia did the same thing against Fred Thomas. You see those things on film. You try and take advantage of any matchup you can during the course of the game.
Hey, what the cop? Cop! For a
second. 2nd and 10. Delay to Bush. And the Eagles fight him down. There were 4 Eagles in on that tackle of Reggie Bush, led by Dahani Jones and Trent Cole.
You know, watching the New Orleans Saints offensive line, they're really doing a great job of doubling those guys up front, getting enough push to get some guys on the linebackers. The run game is there all day long. This offensive line is doing a great job also in picking up the blitzes.
Reggie Bush has averaged over 5 yards a carry. McAllister over 8 yards a carry. 4 yards on the last play, bringing up 3rd and 7. Quick toss, Colston, he's got the first down. Considine makes the shoe-saving tackle at the 5-yard line. It'll be a 19-yard pickup. They'll mark it actually at the 10. Good catch and run by Colston.
Great catch and run by Marcus Colston. A little slant route, breaks a tackle of Sheldon Brown right there. This is one of the things during the course of this winning streak we have not seen from the Philadelphia defense. They have been a very good tackling team during that run. And on that play right there, Marcus Colston was able to break a few.
So it'll be 1st and goal for the Saints. And Marcus Colston setting an NFL rookie record, receiving yards. For the wide receiver, handoff to McAllister, tripped up as he gets to the 4 by Sean Considine. And McAllister limping a bit as he goes back to the huddle. So here they are, the 2 receivers, 2 rookies, Bush and Colston, who combined catches set an NFL record for rookie teammates for the New Orleans Saints. So that's the 2 backs as receivers, very effective this year. Saints, 2nd time they've had a 1st and goal had to settle for a field goal the last time. It'll be second and goal from the four. Bush bounces out. Reggie Bush. Touchdown.
You just can't defend some of the things he does. Watch him go up into the pile. Now you think he's stopped, so everybody on the outside is going to close in. Okay, he's jammed. Right there, he's stuffed. You're thinking that somebody's going to come up and make a tackle. Look at all the Eagles moving in from the defensive left. You know, that's not bad defense. That's just a good individual effort by Reggie Bush.
The New Orleans Saints do a good job of also keeping on and staying on their blocks, even though everybody else on the Eagles' defense stopped. Those offensive linemen and blockers are doing a great job of...
run by Reggie Bush, and the Saints now 97 yards on the ground, and Bush averaging just about 5 yards per carry. McAllister nearly 8. Great 1-2 running punch for the Saints in this first half. John Carney adding the extra point, and the Saints have taken a 13-7 lead. Reggie Bush giving the Saints a 13-7 lead with the touchdown at 5:19 remaining in the first half. Billy Cundiff getting set to kick off. In their earlier meeting this year, the Saints were up 10-0 and then 17-3 at the half before the Eagles rallied and actually took the lead into the fourth quarter. Broderick Hood will down it in the end zone. The Eagles will start from the 20. A 14-play scoring drive that ate up more than 8 minutes, giving the Saints the lead. 13-7. Back here at the Superdome, the Saints leading by a score of 13-7. You know, it was about a year ago, people wondering whether the Saints would actually remain in New Orleans. Talk about moving to Los Angeles. San Antonio wanted them. Look at the response they've had this year. First down from the 20 for the Eagles. Westbrook, and he'll lose a yard. You know, Darrell, one of the big questions coming in as far as the Saints were concerned is their lack of playoff experience. 28 players have never been in postseason. Of course, we know the Eagles have been there many times.
Well, it's what you make out of it. And I think the response we just saw right there by that New Orleans Saints offense shows that experience really isn't a factor. It's all about emotion. And they controlled the flow of this game the entire first quarter. They allow Philadelphia to come out, hit a huge play for a touchdown, grab the lead back. What do they do in that situation? They go on a long drive and recapture the lead.
Second down and 11 from the 19. Garcia again goes to the shotgun. The pass off the hands of Westbrook, bringing up third and 11. Well, right now, we're going to show you how loud this crowd is. You can hear how loud it is.
I'll tell you what, the Philadelphia Eagles can hear how loud it is down here.
The noise, and open is Reggie Brown, and he takes an outside turn and gets a few extra yards, getting into Saints territory. A 32-yard play. Fred Thomas missed him initially.
Well, you heard how loud that noise was. Third and long situation. Again, it's a double move, not a stop and go, but it's going to the post and then back out to the corner. They're turning Fred Thomas around in circles tonight on the outside.
You know, Darrell, they've had receivers open throughout the game. Stallworth, of course, with a touchdown. Brown there and a few even earlier.
Jeff Garcia has not started this game throwing the ball very efficiently, but like last week in that second quarter, he rebounded. He's doing the same thing again tonight.
Getting into rhythm. First down at the 49 of the Saints, and this one off the hands of Stallworth on the slant, bringing up second down and 10.
You ask the players, What is it about Jeff Garcia since he's come in? You know, what is it about him? It's the intangibles. Well, here's an example of it. He's got a guy right in his face. He stands in and delivers the ball, and Dante Stallworth has got to make that catch. His toughness, his competitive nature. Look at him in the huddle. And this guy is pumped up for this game tonight.
Fiery quarterback who has hung in there, playing for the likes of Cleveland and Detroit the last couple of seasons. Second down and 10. And there's a direct snap to Brian Westbrook. And Westbrook gets it out to the 46-yard line, gets three before Josh Cooper, one of the backup defensive tackles, and ends on the same team, makes the play.
You got to get a little bit of a heads up right there. You saw how close Brian Westbrook was standing next to Jeff Garcia pre-snap. You see right there, they just flick it. He jumps over across, takes the direct snap on a run to the outside. I really like the way that both of these offenses incorporate very talented guys, Brian Westbrook and Reggie Bush, into their offenses.
Saints played that well, bringing up third and six. Garcia fires downfield. Hank Baskett with his first catch of the game, giving the Eagles a first down. So once again, the receivers get free, good for 25 yards.
Hank Baskett's in the slot, number 84. There he goes up the field, just running a little corner route right there. That play was made possible by Jeff Garcia's ability to extend the play. Moves outside to his right to find Hank Baskett on the corner route on the outside.
So the Eagles with a first down on the Saints 20. We saw how the Saints responded to the Philadelphia touchdown. Now we're looking at Garcia coming back from Reggie Bush's score. Fake to Buckholter, and the pass to Carell Buckholter, and he is hit as he gets within a couple of yards of the first down marker. Mark Cimino, the former Eagle, making the tackle, and a pickup of 8.
Carell Buckholter, your tailback. He's just going to go take the fake, get down into the middle. He's your outlet receiver for Jeff Garcia. Here comes Dante Stallworth into the screen there. We're trying to get him on a deep in route. He's covered. Just check it down to your running backs and allow them to run with the ball. Now, that was the area that we expected him to go to during the course of this game early on, but I think they like that big play down the field right now.
There, we're winding down to the two-minute warning, and there's Andy Reid and Marty Morenweg, who has handled the play calling duties half the game early in the year, and then the last half all of the play calling. 2 minute warning, we'll be right. 2 minute warning with the score 13-7 in favor of the Saints, but the Eagles moving the ball will have a second down and goal from the 12. Second down and 2 from the 12-yard line. The Eagles have passed 17 times and rushed 9. Almost a 2-to-1 ratio. Will try to pass again. Garcia in a scramble. And he'll get the first down inside the 10. First and goal, Philadelphia. Did not have a receiver, and Garcia, who can scramble, managed to get the first down.
Yeah, you're going to see Hank Baskett pop wide open, but let's not forget that Jeff Garcia is running for his life through the defense. So, yeah, Hank, oh, it was wide open. I can't believe he couldn't find me.
And a timeout called by the Saints, their first timeout. Want to remind you, coming up on the Visa Halftime Report, Kurt, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy will have scores and highlights from around the league. I don't know how many highlights from around the league. We know there's one game played earlier. The Colts beat the Ravens 15-6. And
if you like field goals, there's some highlights going for you.
Adam Vinatieri had 5 of them, tying an NFL postseason record. Second time he's done it.
Defense wins championships.
Touche. You know it, Moose. Don't be coughing like that. I'm eager to see them Chicago Bears defense tomorrow.
And that Seattle Seahawk offense.
First and goal. Ball at the 9. Garcia.
Uh-oh.
Screen to Westbrook, incomplete.
Oh, my goodness. He had a walk-in. What a great play. He gets it up over everybody. Brian Westbrook takes his eyes off the ball right at the last second. And I'm sure what he saw in front of him was a touchdown. That's right, right there. Oh, my goodness. I can't believe I did that.
And Will Smith, little consolation pat. So it'll be second and goal. Slant, L.J. Smith, and he gets it to the goal line, and it was down before he could get over. So he gets to the one-yard line, and the free safety, Josh Bullocks.
Jeff Lurie. He's wondering why that's not a touchdown. I think you're going to see L.J. Smith's knee hit the ground before he does the stretch into the end zone. Let's take a look at this. Yep, down stretch.
Mind you, a little bit of the Rams and Titans in the Super Bowl a few years ago. It'll be third down and goal.
He wants him to take a look at it up in the booth.
And that would be a booth review, of course.
Down.
He's down. And a timeout call by the Eagles. It's their first timeout with 54 seconds remaining in the first half. Eagles called a timeout, hoping there would be a review. There will be no review upstairs. So it'll be third down and goal as Garcia gets the team back into the huddle.
And the officials did a good job catching this at game speed. He goes down before he stretches that ball out towards the goal line. Down short.
Ball is at the one. Hand off to Westbrook. And Westbrook goes in for the touchdown. So Brian Westbrook, after dropping the screen pass and an elated Jeff Lurie, and the Eagles box upstairs cheering the Eagles score here.
Third and short, get in behind Big Sean Andrews. Gives you a little bit of separation right there. Gives Brian Westbrook the opportunity to get up over the top.
An 80-yard drive, 73 through the air and only 7 on the ground. But the one got him into the end zone, so David Akers looking again to break the tie. So the Eagles take a 14-13 lead, 50 seconds remaining in the half. I want to remind you, the Visa halftime report will be coming your way. Kurt, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy will be there to discuss dissect this first half. Winner of this game will play the survivor of tomorrow's game on Fox between the Seahawks and the Bears. What a year for Brian Westbrook. Last week, 141 yards rushing against the Giants. His career best.
You know, he's picked up his production since Donovan McNabb has gone out of the lineup, but also asserted himself as a leader in that locker room, and maybe more important, you know, providing that leadership, because, you know, that's going to be one of the things that's going to be tough to fill when you lose a guy like Donovan McNabb.
Today, Westbrook has carried 6 times for 11 yards, and it's been an aerial show by the Philadelphia offense. They have had receivers open throughout this half. There is that scoring drive, and Garcia hitting 4 of 7 for 73. Akers to kick off. Again, Michael Lewis back. Running up to make the catch at the 10. And dragging defenders out close to the 35-yard line, a 25-yard return. 44 seconds remaining as Drew Brees comes out once more, and he has been effective in the last 2 minutes of either half this season. In fact, that passer rating led the league. 7 touchdowns and only 1 interception.
And Sean Payton is an aggressive play caller, so there's no way that the Saints are going to come out and sit on this ball before halftime. Michael Lewis gives them good field position, a good job of catching that ball on the run to get out to the 35-yard line.
And you never know what you're going to get from Sean Payton, as we saw with onside kicks and on the strange times, as he did against the Dallas Cowboys. Starting from the 35, Brees to Billy Miller. And Miller going out of bounds, short of the first down by a couple. Tony Siragusa.
Yeah, I'm just standing here on the sideline, and David Akers came off, and it was a short kick, and he was screaming at Andy, saying that it wasn't the same ball that he was kicking, that it was an extra hard ball, and he was complaining to the officials, and had a little yelling argument going on here on the sideline.
Well, we know that the kicking balls, or the K-balls as they have it, and of course the Tony Romo play stands up big, will come through an official. An alternate official will sign off, hold him in a pouch on the sidelines. That's something new. Second down and three, and Brees is down, and Jaquay Thomas, who has been a force late in the year, gets Brees and a loss of seven.
Well, Jaquay Thomas and Trent Cole, watch both your guys on the outside. They're going to get upfield. I think Drew Brees does a good job of not turning this ball over right here, because Jaquay Thomas gets his right hand right on Drew Brees' right arm.
Saints call a timeout. They have one remaining. Sean Payton was with the Giants, came in there in 99 when Andy Reid came to the Philadelphia Eagles as head coach. Prior to this year, all of his coaching had been in the NFC East with the Eagles, Giants, and of course, most recently with the Cowboys.
And then how about that? Your first time as head coach, you finally leave the NFC East, go to the NFC South, and who do you get matched up with in the conference? The NFC East, of course.
And in particular, Jim Johnson. And how many times have those two butted heads?
The interesting thing is they know each other so well. And, you know, just from playing against each other, you know, Jim Johnson knows the play calling style of Sean Payton. Sean Payton knows what Jim Johnson likes to do with his pressure packages. So this is going to be a fun chess match to watch in the second half.
And for the most part, Drew Brees has escaped a lot of pressure from Philadelphia. He'll be third down and 10. Brees with a pump fake, but he can't get it off. Darwin Walker makes the tackle from behind, and a loss of three. So the Eagles now will call the timeout, because they have another chance at it. That's their second. And they're going to get the ball on the fourth down. Again tomorrow at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, it'll be the Seattle Seahawks, who beat the Cowboys last week, against the Chicago Bears, who are making their playoff debut this year.
All eyes on Rex Grossman tomorrow.
And of course, Lovie Smith says that he's not going to go to Brian Greasy, that it's Grossman's game. On the other hand, he says, I'll do anything to win. So stay tuned, as they say. Oh, Weatherford running. And Weatherford is going to get the first foul. One man coming in against Weatherford, and he avoided him, and talk about trickery.
I tell you what,
Andy,
what a great...
Reed appreciates that.
Well, watch this. They're going to turn somebody loose right up the middle. Are you kidding me? Sean Barber comes clean right up the middle. Steve Weatherford, what a heady play. He senses the pressure, pulls the ball down. Look at that. They turn him free straight to the punter. Great job by Steve Weatherford, keeping his composure.
Yeah, and he does with 17 seconds remaining, and the Saints on their own 46-yard line. They have one timeout left to try to get it to at least the field goal range. Screen to Reggie Bush. And Bush dives to the 45. Quentin Michael brings him down, and with 7 seconds left, the Saints will use their last timeout. So they get 8 yards on that play. They're on the 45. So what do you do with 7 on the clock?
Throw the Hail Mary. At least they get a shot at the end zone because of Steve Weatherford. But Reggie Bush, the Philadelphia Eagle defense knew he was going to be the wild card. Boy, Sheldon Brown put a hit on him on that first drive, and we weren't sure how productive he was going to be, but he has bounced back from that with some electrifying runs. I mean, the Eagles defense has had him defended. Look at this touchdown run. They've got him defended. They've got him stopped. But sometimes a guy's athletic ability, there's no way to defend it, and he turns that into a touchdown.
Reggie Bush with 34 yards on 7 carries and a touchdown, averaging nearly 5 yards a clip. McAllister has carried 8 times, so they've split it up pretty well between the two. You see Terrence Comfort, number 18, against Tampa Bay. The Saints connected on a Hail Mary at the end of the first half with a long touchdown pass to Terrence Comfort.
Well, they're not running a formation here at the line of scrimmage that that you would think would be effective for that play.
And Brees steps up, and still time on the clock. Devery Henderson was the intended receiver. 2 seconds left.
They were trying to get a few more yards, maybe get an opportunity for John Carney to kick a field goal with the 8 seconds left. Thought they might have been able to take off 10, 12, 15 yards on that play right there. So now they have to go to the Hail Mary.
And if he had caught that pass, Darrell, it would have been a 53-yard attempt for Carney if he had gone out of bounds right there.
If you're going for the Hail Mary right now and you're a defender for the Eagles, you better find where Marcus Colston is right now.
There you see the three wide receivers. Trips on the right. And here goes the pass into the end zone. Comes down. Incomplete. Very nearly caught right there by Colston, I believe. Marcus Colston was right in there, and one of the Eagles are shaken up, but he had an opportunity to make this catch. And William James came in there to knock it away. That's the end of the first half with the score. The Eagles 14, Saints 13. The Visa Halftime Report coming up.
Proud sponsor of the NFL, Life Takes Visa.
And the former Saint Dante Stallworth going back to New Orleans, leading the Eagles to the longest touchdown pass in Eagles playoff history. 75 yards from Jeff Garcia. And right now, that's part of the reason why the Eagles on a 14-13 lead in this playoff matchup at halftime. Hello again, everybody. Kurt Menefee along with Terry, Howie, and Jimmy. And so far, this game has been everything we expected. Ooh. Nip and tuck. Big plays from Philadelphia, but also some good consistent plays, Jimmy, from the Saints and Reggie Bush in particular.
Well, Kurt, going into the draft last year, you know, most of the scouts felt like Reggie Bush was the top player in the draft, and he shows you right here. Second play of the ball game, shows a toughness. Sheldon Brown lights him up. He goes off for a couple plays, but he comes right back in. Then you get the Reggie Bush drive. Third down and 11. Reggie Bush takes the pass from Drew Brees on the screen, picks up the first down. That kind of quickness, you can't create. If you've got that kind of quickness, you can pick up a first down. Third down and 7, they run the draw. First down again. Reggie Bush can make something out of nothing. Here he is. Should have been a 3-yard loss. Instead, he reverses his field, shows the speed, gets in the end zone, gets the touchdown. Special, special player.
Yeah, and one of the things Moose Johnson touched on early in the game was the lack of the deep ball from Philadelphia since Donovan McNabb has gone down, something Jeff Garcia has not been strong on, but they felt like it was something they could take advantage in New Orleans secondary here, early going to Dante Stallworth, probably forcing the ball, went down the field 2 more times before they hit this big play. Classic Jeff Garcia here, buys time with his feet, sets his feet, double move by Dante Stallworth, beats Fred Thomas, has him locked in one-on-one. Former Saint Dante Stallworth, who did not play in the first game with a hamstring injury, coming up big. We got a heck of a ball game.
Yeah, you got to see more McAllister running the ball for the Saints. Bush has definitely been the star in the first half, but Jeff Garcia has outplayed the All-Pro Drew Brees in the first half. Garcia right now carrying the offense for the Eagles. If they win, it's going to be Jeff Garcia who's going to be the hero.
Well, the winner of this game, obviously, moving on to the NFC Championship game. On the AFC side, one team is already there, TB.
All right, Ray Lewis. I wish I could do that. Pull a hammy is what I do. Steve McNair, after a Peyton Manning interception on this drive, drives it down. Intercepted on the 1-yard line by Antoine Bethea, 6-3. Colts, then, on the ensuing drive, Adam Vinatieri nails this 51-yard field goal. Money, 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 Tony. You like it. 9-3 now. Peyton Manning, third quarter back. 27-yard down the middle to Clark. Dallas Clark, cover 2. No safeties in the middle. 12-3, and it's the Colts. Final is 15-6. Peyton Manning, after going 0-4 on the road, the Colts have now won a playoff game on the road. There's your final, 15-6.
And the hero of the game with the golden foot spoke with our Brian Baldinger afterwards.
Adam, 5 for 5 today. That's why they brought you here. I mean, there's no other clutch kicker like you in this league.
I don't know about that. I'm just happy that I could do my part for the team today. You know, the defense played great. You know, Baltimore played a really good game, too. And, you know, if we can get field goal, as long as we win, it doesn't matter how we do it.
Adam, you needed every bit of that crossbar to hit the one from 51 today, which was key for you.
It was. You know, I didn't hit it quite as well as I was hoping. So a little bit of luck on that, you know, to get it that far. So I guess as long as they go in, it doesn't matter.
And with that luck, Colts in the AFC title game for the second time in the last 4 years. All right, some of you will be getting local news after the break. The rest of you will come right back here and get you set for tomorrow's matchup between the Bears and Seattle and see who will play in that game against the winner of this one.
Hit it. Offense at dead end, defense down here.
Mike Holmgren directing traffic and hoping he can direct his team to the NFC Championship game for the second straight year. That game seen right here on Fox tomorrow, noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. And we've got a matchup, Jimmy, between the number one seed and the defending NFC champ that no one's talking about.
Kurt, you look at this game and you say, okay, about 100 players, about 40 coaches, all kinds of trainers, everybody on the field, and they're all going to talk about one player, Rex Grossman. What kind of game is he going to have? The last time they played, 2 touchdowns. He played outstanding. But he has had some bad games at the end of the year. I think he'll be at his best. He's gotten ready for this game. It's not New Year's Eve. He'll be ready to play.
Yeah, just remember the last time these two teams played, Seattle had just smoked the New York Giants with their new 3-4 wide receiver package, and they weren't ready for the pressure that came with that, where to go with the football. I think they're going to get back. They didn't have Sean Alexander. They'll get back to running the football, trying to get manageable third downs. Don't get down early and allow that D-line to tee off.
Sometimes you just have to look to the heavens and say, boy, this could be our year. Seattle really should not be in this game. But a botched field goal attempt by the Cowboys, Tony Romo, puts them here. They have 4 cornerbacks that are out of this game. Trufant, Williams, and Herndon out of this football game. And Rex Grossman lit the starters up the first time. I expect Rex Grossman to outplay the other guy.
That's two guys on the Rex Grossman bandwagon.
So much of the game, the quarterback is played from the neck up. You'll appreciate that. Rex Grossman, is he ready mentally? Did he go to study hall this week?
Was that a shot?
No.
Well, he will tell us if he didn't, considering he did last time. All right. That game, noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, right here on Fox tomorrow. How about the second half of the early matchup today in the NFC? It comes your way right after this.
Eagles lead 14-13 as we get set for the second half. The 2006 NFL Punt, Pass, and Kick Program National Finals took place earlier tonight here in the Superdome, and we'll meet the champions in their respective age groups at the start of the fourth quarter.
Good to see that back in the NFL.
Been around a long time and giving kids from all the cities that have NFL teams and others a chance to compete there. And Darrell, do you have any experiences in the punt, pass, and kick?
I did. I didn't make it to the final round, but I got to the AFC round. And
what happened?
Well, we won't get into what happened with me in my performance. Didn't do too well in the performance, but we actually got to stay in the hotel where the Pittsburgh Steelers were staying. So I had an opportunity to meet Lynn Swann and our own Terry Bradshaw when I was 10 years old.
How'd that go?
It went well. I went up to ask him for an autograph while I was having dinner with his wife, and he said, go away, young man. And his wife made him sign my signature. So
that's nice. Well, a great experience for these kids. And I want to tell you what happened at the end of the first half. You know, it was an incomplete pass in the end zone with Marcus Colston battling for the ball, had a chance to make the catch, and that was ruled the end of the half. But the Saints came out. The Eagles went into the locker room, and the Saints came out, and Sean Payton felt that Colston had possession and should be credited with a touchdown. The Saint players came out on the field. The Eagles were in the locker room. Andy Reid came in and said, look, for all you stragglers, get back into the locker room. And that was the end of that. So a little drama after the end of the half as the Hail Mary went for naught. And we're set for the third quarter. And the Eagles will get the ball first. Billy Cundiff will be kicking off to Roderick Hood. So after a 3-0 first quarter with the field goal by Carney, 6-0 in favor of New Orleans, and then 3 touchdowns in a row. Roderick Hood returning for the Eagles to start this third quarter, and he is slammed down by Danny Clark. Take a look now at the first half statistics. See, the Eagles only 1.3 yards per rush compared to the Saints, but what about the aerial game for Philadelphia?
Yeah, Philadelphia has had to go through the air to get their yards and move the ball today, and there's your telltale sign about that layoff. Philadelphia coming back on the short week, 6 days. New Orleans having an opportunity to get the bye, to get rested. We thought that that might show up in the run game performance, and obviously in the first half, it's paid huge dividends for the New Orleans Saints. The Eagles not able to establish any running game yet.
Only 14 yards on the ground. Slant pass caught by Dante Stallworth and a first down to the 32. Tony, what did you find out at halftime?
Well, I talked with Andy Reid, and he says he wants to be very aware when they're on offense of where Fred Thomas is going to be. He thinks that they can take advantage of him. And also on defense, he feels like he's getting a little bit too much push up there with his defensive lineman. He wants to run some stunts and try and get some penetration and keep the pressure on defense.
At the end of that first half, Sean Barber in that end zone Hail Mary attempt was shaken up. And he was taken off on a card. Westbrook goes in motion to the right. Garcia taking off. And Garcia goes down about 5 yards shy of the first down. Let's take a look at the injury update. Sean Barber with an injured ankle and questionable as to whether he'll be back. Sean Andrews, who has been the outstanding right guard, making the Pro Bowl, doubtful as to his return. And Scott Young, number 71, has replaced him. There he is to the right of Jamal Jackson.
Well, if they had trouble running it in the first half, it's going to be harder in the second half with Sean Andrews out of that lineup.
Second down and four. Here's Westbrook. First down.
Maybe not.
Westbrook. And there's Westbrook racing to the 20-yard line. One man has a shot at him, and he gets in for the touchdown. Carried Josh Bullock's in for the score. 57 yards for Westbrook, and that is his second touchdown of the game.
I tell you, the big play has been the Achilles heel of this Saints defense all season long, and here it is again. We've got a 75-yard pass play in the first half, and now here comes Brian Westbrook. I don't know what happened with the defense there. They don't have enough guys on the right side of the, or the, their defensive left side of the line to make that stop.
They're calling it a 62-yard run by Westbrook. So Brian Westbrook, who went over from 1 yard out, runs 62 yards this time, and the Eagles extend their lead. Akers with the extra point. And it is an 8-point lead for Philadelphia. The Eagles lead the Saints 21-13.
Well, if you look on this play, this is the last run play. You see these both defensive linemen right here. Charles Grant and Brian Young have an inside move. Both of the linebackers need to fill. They did a great job of getting to the second level. That's what happened on that play right there.
And then LJ Smith got two guys, came to the outside, kicked Mike McKenzie out, and then went up onto the safety.
62-yard run, the Eagles' longest postseason run. And they had the long pass play as well, the 75-yarder from Garcia to Stallworth. Here's Michael Lewis on the return of the kickoff. Cutting upfield, and a good return by Lewis of 36 yards as he brings it out to the 37-yard line. Decent field position for the Saints, who trail by 8. Eagles lead 21-13. Felt they could move the ball against the Saints and have done it. And they've done it through the air and on the ground, as Westbrook proved. Now the Saints trying to answer. First down on the 37. Hand off to McAllister. Deuce McAllister averaging nearly 8 yards a carry and 63 yards in the first half. Picks up 7. Reno Mahe, the punt returner for the Eagles, being worked on. Second down and 3. Marcus Colston has 4 catches to lead the Saints in the first half. Reggie Bush with the handoff. First down, Bush getting close to midfield. Tackled by Trent Cole, and he gets 5 yards. Marcus Colston, we said, with 4 catches and 6'4 frame and solid hands, Darrell.
Yeah, one of the things that he really does a great job of is catching it away from his body. And this is a drill from a college coach at Hofstra. They would paint the end of the ball and put symbols on it. And he would look it in, and then he would read the top symbol on the ball, on the top panel, and have to tell the coach what symbol it was. It makes you concentrate all the way through the catch and not taking your eyes away and moving downfield when you could drop the pass.
That's an assistant coach at Hofstra that has done that with Colston. Meanwhile, 5-yard pass to McAllister, but
10-yard penalty, still first down.
But a penalty on Jamal Brown, the left tackle, who's going to his first Pro Bowl, will nullify that gain and bring the Saints back into their own territory.
His coach, Jamie Elizondo, came up with that drill. And for any young guys out there, any coaches out there, I think it's a great drill because it really does make you concentrate all the way through the catch. And even at the NFL level, you'll see sometimes, and we saw with Brian Westbrook earlier in the game, on that screen pass when it's going to be a walk-in touchdown, he took his eyes off the ball right at the very end. He didn't look it all the way in, and that's how come you have incomplete passes at times.
From the 39, play action, Brees stepping up and completes it to Billy Miller, who was signed in week 7, played 3 years with the Houston Texans, picks up 15 yards, and still 5 yards short of the first down are the Saints, but they get back into the Eagle area at the 46. We talked about Colston and how he was picked in the 7th round, and the Saints respond by saying, you know, if we knew he was going to be this good, we wouldn't have waited until the 7th round to draft him.
Well, he's going to remember that when his contract comes
up. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Second down and 5. Here's McAllister with a burst. And Deuce McAllister gets the first down and dragged down some more as he gets a couple of extra yards inside the 35-yard line. Jeremiah Trotter.
Mike Carney motions back in. He's just going to get behind him. Strong side lead. Good adjustment by Mike Carney to get inside the block and find his way to Dahani Jones.
12-yard gain.
Here we go. Here we go.
And a first down at the 34 of the Eagles. And that pass thrown behind Colston. No chance to make that play. How about the Saints, Darrell, have rushed for 136 already? And we're not even halfway through this third quarter, and they find themselves on the short end by 8 points.
Well, it's the big plays again. You know, they're controlling the flow of the game with their offense running the football. They've really, at one point, had taken Brian Westbrook and this Eagles offense ground game out of it. And then it only takes one snap. When you've got a guy with the ability that Brian Westbrook has, it takes one snap for him to go the distance. Got a great block by L.J. Smith.
Second down and 10. Brees up the middle, pass is caught at the 10, and getting close to the 5-yard line is Billy Miller, 28-yard gain. So Miller, a big factor here on the receiving end, a huge gain here.
Reggie Bush is becoming a complete player in the NFL at the running back spot. Watch him come in, get Jeremiah Trotter, chop him down. That gives Drew Brees the time to find Billy Miller down the seam.
Third catch of the game. 50 yards, and now the Saints have a first and goal at the 5, and it looks like a boxing match. Whoever's the last man standing, it appears, may end up winning this game. First and goal from the 5. Here's McAllister trying to push the pile, and he does a good job of it. He gets in, touchdown!
That's an unbelievable job on that offensive line of keeping their feet moving.
Deuce McAllister, pile driving his way into the end zone for the touchdown that the Saints badly needed at this stage of the game.
Unbelievable effort by Deuce McAllister, and as Tony pointed out, watch all the offensive linemen and his lead fullback, Mike Kearney, stay on their feet. They keep pushing the pile, pushing the pile. Deuce McAllister just gets in behind him. A great team effort by that offensive line and the fullback to make sure Deuce McAllister gets in the end zone.
Terrific determination by the veteran Deuce McAllister in the playoffs for the first time in his career. And John Carney's extra point brings the Saints to within 1. 9:36 to go in the third. It's a battle royal here at the Superdome. So the Eagle lead is down to 1 after Philadelphia had scored 2 straight touchdowns before that point. a 63-yard drive. And McAllister going over from five. So we have had Reggie Bush score a touchdown, Deuce McAllister and Brian Westbrook score two. Billy Cundiff with the kick. Reno Mahe. And he flips. And on the reverse, William James. And it was Avant, not James, on the return. And a 39-yard game when it's all over. Back here at the Louisiana Superdome. Eagles 21, Saints 20. Jason Avant on that reverse on the kickoff return, and the Eagles on their 46-yard line, first down. Garcia lost it in the air and trying to get it to Greg Lewis, incomplete, coverage by Jason Kraft. Well, the Eagles have been a big play team, not so much since Jeff Garcia took over as quarterback, but they're back to it tonight, Darryl.
They really are. You see right there, postseason records, one pass, one run, and it's been the Achilles heel of the Saints all season. But as you pointed out, since Jeff Garcia has come in, it's been more of the running game, kind of a dink and dunk approach. But they have felt so strongly about some of those matchups on the outside, especially with Fred Thomas, that they've kind of gotten back to what they were doing earlier in the season. It's paid huge dividends for them tonight.
Westbrook lining up wide to the right. Second down and 10. Terrell Buchholter in the backfield, and it's going to be Westbrook on the handoff. And Westbrook wending his way into Saints territory, getting a first down. So call it an end around, if he will, 20 yards for Brian Westbrook.
Well, here he comes. He's coming around this way. Now, what happens over here on the defensive side of the ball? I mean, somebody's got to have contain. Somebody's got to be yelling something. Will Smith is on the fast track down inside to get Carell Buchholter. His responsibility is contain. And somebody's got to relay a message that 36 is coming in motion. Watch the reverse. Watch the end around. It's unbelievable that he would chase that backside down when he's got contained.
Well, they did set that play up because earlier they did run a reverse, but they didn't hand it off just to see what those backs would do.
And a first down, Carell Buchholter, and he's going to be hit behind the line of scrimmage in a loss of a couple. Charles Grant was right in on the play. Talk about the Eagles getting underway slowly in the rushing game. Westbrook now has 91 yards rushing and 62 of them coming on the touchdown run.
Well, it's a commitment to the run now. You know, we talked about what they've been doing since Jeff Garcia, the Eagles offense, since he's taken over. It's come into balance a lot more than it was in previous seasons or even earlier in the year. And there's a commitment. They stay with it. And when you got a big play hitter like Brian Westbrook, when you can get the ball to him, you have to stay with that run game.
Here's the crowd again.
Looks like Fred Thomas is in man-to-man coverage, too.
Here comes the pressure on Garcia. And he gets it away, but unable to hold on was Thomas Tepe out of the backfield. And it was Westbrook who cut over the middle.
Splits wide out to the right, just a drag across the middle. Again, just kind of sneaking a little peek. You're coming back into the middle of the field. He's got to get with Marcus Colston's college coach and start working on that drill.
Third down and 12 from the 38. Garcia, incomplete off the hands of Hank Basket. Fourth down, and Dirk Johnson coming on to punt.
Here comes your pressure on the outside. Carell Buchholter steps up. He lets Scott Fujita get too much steam going. He's got to shorten that distance. Get up there, set his hips down, deliver a blow.
Michael Lewis back at the 10. Trying to keep it inside the 20. And will do that successfully, and is down by the Eagles. And they'll mark it at the 17. 1-point lead for the Eagles. 7:26 to go in the third. The Eagles by one, Saints ball. There's Joe Horn, who has been out with a groin injury, try to go, unable to do it tonight. First down at the 16. Drew Brees on the screen to Deuce McAllister. And McAllister may have enough for the first down. What an exhibition of running and pass receiving by McAllister of the Saints and Westbrook tonight of the Eagles.
They have done a great job, and you know, both of these offenses are so good at running the screenplays, and a lot of that has to do with the personnel, whether it's Reggie Bush or Deuce McAllister for the Saints, Brian Westbrook for the Eagles, really staples of that offense. And it's just you take advantage of all that Eagles pressure, you slip one of those guys out and get him on the screen.
First down at the 27-yard line, and Reggie Bush gets knocked back, maybe a yard on the play by Darwin Walker. And the play was blown dead. Well, tomorrow night at 8, 7 Central, don't miss the explosive two-night, four-hour season premiere of 24. Jack is back, and a new day begins tomorrow at 8, 7 Central, right here, only on Fox. Viewer discretion is advised.
Kind of bittersweet this time of year.
Yes, it is.
This is our last playoff game, and our work is done, but 24 starts too, so there is a good side to this time of year for us.
And of course, Fox football goes on. Of course, tomorrow, the Seahawks and Bears. From Soldier Field, Drew Brees drills it, pass caught, and it's Billy Miller with a first down at the 40-yard line. He's been a big factor, 13-yard pickup.
He really has, you know, throughout the course of the game. He's just going down. He's finding some soft spots in that zone defense. Sheldon Brown just a little bit late getting over there, but a good feel as he's releasing downfield into that soft area.
Four catches, 63 yards for Miller, and they were forced to bring him in when Ernie Conwell went out with injury. He's the backup to Mark Campbell, and a first down now at the 40. And Reggie Bush is going to lose a bunch right there as he is knocked back to the 35, a loss of five, Omar Gaither. Take a look at the team leaders right now as the clock runs toward 5 minutes to go in the third. Drew Brees, just a shade under 200 yards passing. No touchdowns, no interceptions. Big game for Deuce McAllister with 88 yards. And now Billy Miller has four catches, the same number as Marcus Colston. Second and 15. They fake a pass and give to Reggie Bush. And Bush loses the ball. And a fumble at the 48-yard line. And it's recovered by the Saints. And great hustle downfield. And it's going to be Terrence Copper who recovered the fumble. Big alert play by him.
Terrence Copper at the top of your screen. What a heads-up play. He's the only Saint over there. There's five Philadelphia Eagles. Staying involved in the play, keeping his eyes on what's happening. Reggie Bush has got that ball kind of out. Jeremiah Trotter comes in, gets a good hand on it, rips it out of there. Good hustle play by Terrence Copper.
So the Saints get 16 yards, not all, of course, by Reggie Bush. And a first down at the 49 of Philadelphia. Drew Brees stepping up, going to McAllister underneath. And he won't go anywhere as he's stopped at the 50 by Dahani Jones and will lose one on the play.
They're still doing a good job, Tony. They're dumping that ball off. The break by the linebackers in the secondary of the Philadelphia Eagles has been impressive all game. Nowhere to go for these guys when they get it dumped down short.
Yeah, they're really on top of it, watching whoever lines up in the backfield. I'm really surprised that they're getting away from the run. I mean, Deuce McAllister early, we saw him have some serious runs, and every time he touches the ball, it seems like he has a 5 or 6 yard gain.
Reggie Bush lining up behind Brees has gained 40 yards on 11 carries thus far. This will be a pass attempt. And it's caught, flagged down at the 30. John Owens, who is the third tight end on the Saints, makes the grab for 16 yards and a penalty flag down.
How many times have we seen that play tonight by this Saints offense? Getting the tight end down the seam into almost the same area each play.
Holding defense. First down.
You know, we see that play over and over again, but we got to give a little bit of credit to Drew Brees. I mean, he's throwing. You see Marquise Colston right here going out, but he's throwing in traffic and making those plays over the middle, doing a great job watching him down here in the end zone.
And the holding penalty declined, so John Owens and Billy Miller making key catches for the Saints, the tight ends, as Darryl pointed out, and a first down for New Orleans on the Philadelphia 29. Bush stumbling forward and getting 9 yards, but a flag is back at the line of scrimmage.
Holding offense number 70. 10-yard penalty. Still first down.
So the holding penalty against Jamal Brown will nullify that 9-yard pickup.
Great balance by Reggie Bush. I thought he was going to be knocked down for a gain of about 3 yards. Don't know how he was able to kind of keep his balance there. Watch this. Almost loses the ball again, so he starts to stumble as he gets the security. He's just able to maintain that balance.
First down and 20 on the 39-yard line of the Eagles. Here's Brees again, and down he goes, and coming up the middle and making the play is Trent Cole. That's the second sack of the game for Cole, who led the Eagles this year with 8, but did not have any in the last 4 games. A flag is down, however, way down in the defensive secondary at the 25.
Wow.
And let's see whether the Eagles might have been holding in the secondary.
Well, the quarterback was in the pocket. Illegal contact. Defense number 55.
So instead of a loss on the play and a sack, Dehani Jones called for illegal contact, giving the Saints a first down at about the 34.
Not a whole lot there. Dehani Jones beyond the 5 yards, but boy, that's a backbreaker for that defense.
Here's McAllister. Here's McAllister cutting upfield. And he gets down to the 10-yard line. What a brilliant run by McAllister. And Tony pointed it out right on the money, are you, Tony? 23 yards. Sheldon Brown finally takes him down.
I mean, the vision that Deuce McAllister has, and it seems like he's going down, and he just gets another 8 yards. You see him right here in the backfield. Makes a good job, cuts it right there, and just drives right through the block. It was an arm tackle that would have took down most guys, but goes and gets a great run out of something that should have been stopped on the line of scrimmage.
So McAllister now with 111 yards rushing in the game. It'll be first down and 10 from the 11. Saints can get a first down without scoring, and they swing it out to Deuce McAllister, who will go in for the touchdown. What a show put on by McAllister tonight.
Boy, does he put a move on Jeremiah Trotter. Watch 54. He actually plays this pretty well. He sees Deuce flare out, gets under that route. Okay, I'm right in position. Oh, boy, oh, boy.
He's got the power and he's got the moves, Moose.
That's a nice little shake out there.
11 yards, scoring pass. And the Saints, who are trailing by 8 now, have a 26-21 lead. And John Carney aboard. So this game turning into what many people expected to be a high-scoring affair. Extra point is good. And the Saints now lead 27-21. McAllister, who had the best day of his career against the Eagles 3 years ago, having another banner game.
Well, he started the game playing in this way, and we've been wondering why they haven't been feeding it to him more. Usually Sean Payton will lean on the hot hand, and it's just been Deuce McAllister up the middle, making people miss, running physical. Look at this one, the whole group pushing the pile, getting him into the end zone. But he can do a little bit of everything. You flare him out to the outside, he freezes Jeremiah Trotter and gets into the end zone.
So the Saints go 86 yards in 9 plays, And McAllister with two touchdowns, 131 total yards. The crowd was a bit down when the Eagles scored two touchdowns to take a 21-13 lead. And now the team huddling around on the sideline. Well, this team has been a together team all the way, and it was amazing because this has been a kind of a ragtag franchise over the years, you know, to be frank, and finally to have a cohesive team once in a while like this is phenomenal as Reno Mahe returns the kick to the 28-yard line. Tomorrow it'll be the Seahawks, the defending NFC champions, against the Chicago Bears, the number one seed.
I thought Jimmy Johnson made a good point at the halftime show. There's so many people involved in this game. He had all the focus is on one guy. Everything is on Rex Grossman. And you know, in those types of games, it's going to be somebody else who steps up and is the difference maker for one team or the other.
This crowd has waited a long time for this. First playoff bye in the 40-year history of the franchise. Garcia hit, stays on his feet, and off the head of the defender, Mark Cimino, downfield. Garcia did well, Darrell, just to get away from the pressure.
Oh, this is something you can't teach, the pocket presence. I don't even know how he felt that, but rattled a little bit where he couldn't get enough touch on that. Mark Cimino makes the play off the back of his head, trying to catch up to Karell Buchholter, but Jeff Garcia felt that pressure from an unblocked man and was able to get up in the pocket to at least give that play a chance.
Second down and 10 from the 30. Play action. And Garcia ducking down. And the pass caught by L.J. Smith after bobbling it makes the play at the 45 for 15 yards. A fiery, gutty quarterback, Jeff Garcia, three-time Pro Bowler, will turn 37 next month.
I just can't believe how good he is while he's moving around to be able to keep his eyes down the field with everything going on around him, the speed of this game, how fast it's moving, and he's able to just scan the secondary and find these open guys.
First down at the 45 of Philadelphia. And here is Stallworth with the catch. And Dante Stallworth works his way to the 41-yard line. Gain of 14 as time runs out. That is the end of the third quarter with the score. The Saints 27, the Eagles 21. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we direct your attention to the north end zone, where we would like to recognize the national champions of the 2006-2007 NFL Punt, Pass, and Kick program. Cedric Jones, Senior Director of Youth Football for the National Football League, and Richard Wilson, representing the program's title sponsor, will congratulate the eight national champions. The eight nine-year-old champions are Sidney Palmer from Pier, South Dakota, and Logan Weckerly from Monroe, Wisconsin. In the 10 to 11 age group, Sarah Firestone from Mercersburg, Pennsylvania, and Ryan Garner from Dyer, Tennessee. The 12 and 13 year old champions are Shelby Sullivan from Richardson, Texas, and Jeff Lance from Parkersburg, West Virginia. And finally, the 14 and 15-year-old champions are Caroline Farchman from Mission Hills, Kansas, and Josh Couch from Carlisle, Ohio. The National Football League would like to thank all of the participants and volunteers who made the Punt, Pass, and Kick a successful program in 2006. For more information, please visit the website at www.nflrush.com. Let's give our national champions another round of applause. And And we start the fourth quarter here. Dick Stockton along with Darryl Johnston and Tony Siragusa. Been a seesaw game. Saints were up 13-7. The Eagles took a 21-13 lead early in the third. But two touchdowns by New Orleans. They're up 27-21. Been no turnovers by either team in this game. And a first down for the Eagles on the Saint 42. Garcia to run it. He'll get the first down. Flag is down back at the 35-yard line. So Garcia going out of bounds, picking up the necessary yardage.
Offense number 71. 10-yard penalty is still first down.
So that's Scott Young, the right guard, who replaced the injured Sean Andrews. And that nullified a 22-yard scamper by Garcia.
Oh. Jeff Garcia just did a great job on that. And it wasn't four guys rushing either move. They had five guys on that rushing, and he found the way to get out of there.
Unbelievable. He caught him in man coverage, too, so you got everybody running away. Man underneath. The only guy that could try and make a play on that was the safeties who were back in zone. But it's all coming back.
Eagles back on their own 48. Just got the playoff in time, and Garcia has an open receiver, and it's Reggie Brown who makes the catch. And a good play by Brown, keeping both feet in bounds, getting control, and a first down, picking up 24. And he's on the 28-yard line.
Well, there's some confusion right now, because look at Reggie Brown. There he is on the sideline. There's two Saint defenders about 10 yards behind him to the inside. Now, I know that Sean Payton's an innovative play caller, but you can't dial up something that gets somebody that wide open unless you've got a blown coverage.
First down at the 28. Here comes pressure. Handoff to Westbrook. And Westbrook running close to the 10 yards. Line gets 15. And tackled at the 13-yard line. Westbrook with a big game, has 106 yards rushing.
Patience to the hole, explosion through the hole. And that's what Brian Westbrook did on that play. The Saints had it defended well on the front side of the play, but because he was under control, he was able to break it to the backside and get into the secondary.
First down and 10 yards to go at the 13. And the pitch going to Westbrook off the left side. And Westbrook trying to get the first down would have to get to the 3-yard line. Josh Bullock's in there, and it's very close. Huge game for Westbrook coming off a career high a week ago.
Yeah, that was the easy one so far. This is a great run right here. And the Philadelphia ground game had really been halted all night until that play right there. And since that play, they have been able to run the ball a lot more effectively throughout the second half.
Second down and goal. Second and one at the 4-yard line. And here is Westbrook, and he's stopped by the Saints before getting the necessary yardage. You talked about how the Eagles have stepped up the running game. They had 11 yards rushing at the end of the first half. They have 122 to this point early here in the fourth.
Just watching those backside ends are really coming downhill fast down the line of scrimmage. No one's paying attention to Jeff Garcia on that naked or bootleg.
Well, they also got Brian Westbrook on the play that got him down here to this position. They faked to Thomas Depay inside and flipped it to him on the quick pitch, and the defensive end chased down inside again.
Third down and one. Garcia getting rid of it to Thomas Depay and written out of bounds. Scott Fujita with a big play. On third down, a loss of two.
They run the little bootleg to the outside. Jay Bellamy reads it. He's on the blitz. Gets in, forces Jeff Garcia to pull it up. Scott Fujita coming from the inside out on Thomas Depay. That play didn't have a chance because of the blitz by Jay Bellamy.
So the Saints are up by six, and David Akers will try to cut it in half with a 24-yard field goal attempt. That is Akers. And the kick by David Akers is good. First field goal of the game for Akers, and the Saints lead now 27-20. Seen at Bourbon Street here in New Orleans, and the entire region revived after the horrific experience of Hurricane Katrina. Eagles go 9 plays, 64 yards, and David Akers with a field goal, and the Saints lead is 3. It's almost like the heavyweight fight. Whoever gets that last punch in is going to win this one. Michael Lewis returning for the Saints. And a good return out to the 35-yard line.
He's done a good job all night of putting the Saints offense in good field position to start their drives.
My dad is coach of the year. Sean Payton's kids should be very proud of what he has accomplished. Saints with a first down at the 35, leading by 3. Drew Brees will go down. Could not get it out on the flat to Reggie Bush, and Darwin Walker picks up the sack and a loss of 6 yards. But you know, they're, it's kind of game that you got to take advantage of every opportunity, and the Eagles had a golden one the last time they had the ball, Darrell.
Yeah, they really did. They had second and one inside the 5-yard line and came away with a field goal. So, keep an eye on that. That would have got it back to 28-27 Philadelphia. Right there on that last play, you mentioned that Drew Brees trying to get that ball out to Reggie Bush on the swing pass. Roderick was waiting for him again. Thank goodness for Drew. He didn't throw it to him because he would have got blown up like he did earlier in the game.
Second down and 16, and they flip it up underneath to Reggie Bush, not going anywhere that time, as he is stopped by Omar Gaither, the rookie from Tennessee.
You know, Andy Reid did tell me going into halftime, like I said earlier, that they were going to try and do some more stunts. Right now, they're just rushing four up front and getting a lot of pressure of just moving around and putting a lot of pressure on Drew Brees.
Notice that the Saints sideline hiding the signals with a big white towel. Third down and 16. Saints have scored touchdowns on both of their possessions here in the second half, but face third and long. Brees stepping up, and that doesn't go anywhere. Reggie Bush claiming he was held on the play. No flags down, so it's fourth down, and Weatherford will come into punt.
Yeah, Reggie Bush got bumped on the way out, and he kind of gave up on that route. I think that's what Sean Payton's getting on him right now about, as he released up inside. Jaquay Thomas just gave him a shot, took him off of his stride, so all of a sudden he kind of shut it down on the play. Drew Brees needs him to get open to go with the ball somewhere.
Weatherford will kick, and Brian Westbrook back to return the punt for the second time tonight. And he gets tripped up. Otherwise, he might have picked up a few. Danny Clark making the play. So Payton, the teacher, with his number one draft pick. A big stop by the Eagles, who have another opportunity here. Well, the dream is going to end for one of these teams tonight. The Eagles, who have won 6 in a row after people counted them out. And the Saints coming back from 3 wins last year to win a division. First down at the 37 for Jeff Garcia and Philadelphia. Pump fake. And Garcia's pass thrown into the Eagle bench.
Philadelphia's defense came up with a big stop on that last series. Gets this offense right back on the field. And Tony, we were talking at that break. It just seems like the Saints want to get away from Deuce McAllister in that run game.
You know, just the run game will go and take some time off the clock, put you in a better position, and they went 3 passes in that last series. And now, you know, the Eagles, like you said, Moose, are in good field position right now to move the ball.
Saints have gained 170 on the ground. The Eagles catching up at 122. Second and 10 at the 37, and here's Westbrook. And nothing much there. No gain on the play. Well, Tuesday night at 8, 7 Central, get ready for the 2-hour season premiere of American Idol. The dream is back, and so are America's best and worst talents. Don't miss the season premiere on Tuesday at 8, 7 Central, right here only on Fox.
I don't know about you guys, but I like the worst better than the best. What do you guys?
Half and half. Third and 10. Garcia trying to lead Greg Lewis to no avail. Fourth down. So the Saints, after being stopped on offense by the Eagles, come right back and halt Philadelphia's bid, and they'll have to punt.
How about that? Both defenses flexing their muscles at critical times. These offenses have had their way all game long. The Eagles get a three and out, get the ball back. The Saints come right back and match them.
Dirk Johnson will kick, and Reggie Bush, whose first touchdown this year was on a punt return against Tampa Bay, is back.
Got some room to work.
At the 19 is Bush. And he manages to get to the 28, and that's all. 8:20 remaining in the fourth quarter as the Saints lead by three. And Andy Reid and Sean Payton went at it in October right here at the Superdome. The score was what it is now, 27-24. The Saints winning on the field goal by Carney as the game came to an end. 8:20 remaining here. First down on the 29. McAllister. Why not go give it to McAllister, Tony, as he's had a great game. Picks up 7 yards and tempers flare momentarily. Take a look at the two quarterbacks and how they fared thus far, Garcia and Brees. One thing they've done is that they avoided mistakes.
Yeah, we haven't had a turnover yet in this game, so well played on both sides of the ball.
Pretty even.
Well, the earlier matchup came down to who had the ball last. It looks like we're heading that way again tonight.
Second down and three, McAllister. And he is shy of the first down. In that previous game, the Saints went 8.5 minutes to set up that winning field goal after falling behind to the Eagles. Not as much of a margin between the two teams as we had in the first meetup, 17-3. One time the Saints were up, needed a touchdown to tie it up. 7 minutes remaining. Third and one, first down. Deuce McAllister up to the 40 with Cole and Dawkins in on the play.
Well, they listened to you, Tony. Last time, three passes, three and out. This time, three handoffs to Deuce McAllister.
And you get a first down. And the good thing about it is you see at the top of your screen right there, that clock is ticking. And that's exactly what the New Orleans Saints want to have happen. Run the clock out. Don't give the Eagles the ball back with a lot of time left on there so they can go down the field and bite you.
McAllister with 121 yards on 15 carries. He has a touchdown averaging 8 yards a clip. Again, McAllister, and Deuce picks up about 1.5 yards.
I like it better when they've got Mike Carney in there in front of Deuce McAllister. That time they go to a two tight end, two wide receiver set. It's a single back running game. It's a little bit different. I know they do a lot of things offensively, but they've got Billy Miller back there in the fullback spot.
Second and 8, play action. Brees has time, and this pass over the head of Terrence Copper. So the Saints taking a shot right there against Sheldon Brown.
That looked very similar to a play we saw that first time. The Saints had just given up the lead. They came back, ran a double move on a bootleg, and they got Joe Horn that time down the middle of the field to regain the lead. It looked like that exact same play. Eagles were waiting on it.
Tony making a good point, as the Saints would like to use a lot of that clock if they can get it down and get 3 points at least from Carney, force the Eagles with little time to need a touchdown to pull this game out. Third down and 8. Colston, first down at the 45 on the slant from Brees, and a pickup of 13. That's the fifth catch of the game by Marcus Colston.
They got the slant routes. They got double slants out to the right side. There goes Marcus Colston. William James playing off on him. The big guy gets inside, makes the catch for the first down.
James is the nickel back with the injury to Lito Shepard, the former New York Giant who was signed in week 9, was known as Will Peterson when he played for the Giants for 5 years. But there's Colston's numbers and a first down at the 45 of Philadelphia. Here's Reggie Bush cutting outside. Reggie Bush, and he is collared down. No horse collar, but taken down after an 8-yard pickup by Roderick Hood.
Watch this cut by Reggie Bush to the outside. He gets up into the hole, and then right here, the squares out to the outside. All the pursuit is coming from the outside in. He almost gets to the corner. Does a good job staying in bounds.
And Moose, you pointed it out. Got Carney there in the backfield, number 44. You see it right there. Reggie Bush follows him right through the hole. The hole widens right up. That's what Moose has been talking about, pumping up his fellow fullbacks throughout the league all year this year.
It's about time we mentioned the fullback.
Yeah, we got a good one in Mike Carney out there tonight.
Second down and 3. McAllister this time, first down. So the great 1-2 punch of Deuce McAllister and Reggie Bush. Bush has 52 yards, McAllister 123.
This Eagle defense looks worn down right now, getting pounded. Them linemen for the Saints are really going and dominating on the line of scrimmage. And we see it right here, first down after first down.
As Tony's pointed out, take a look up at the top of your monitor right there on that clock. You get that running game moving, you keep your guys in bounds. The Philadelphia Eagles are reeling right now, and again, we've mentioned it before earlier tonight, this is the one area that possibly that six-day to 13-day rest might show its effects.
Saints have a first down on the Eagles 35. Here's McAllister. And McAllister gets 3 yards. Trotter is right there in the middle to make the tackle.
Well, now the Eagles got to start making decisions whether they call timeouts or not, and right there you see a timeout called. But that clock is like Moose and everybody's been talking about, is wearing down, and you're running out of time if you're the Eagles.
And the Eagles call a timeout, stopping the clock with 3:21 to go. Jeff Fain was slow getting up, but he appears to be in okay here. Back here at the Louisiana Superdome, the New Orleans Saints never have won a game to get to the NFC Championship game in their 40-year history. The Philadelphia Eagles, who were in the Super Bowl 2 years ago, seek their 5th trip in the last 6 seasons for the NFC title game. That's what's at stake here. Eagles calling their first timeout. It'll be second down and 7 for the Saints at the 32. The flip off the hands of Reggie Bush, and the Eagles may have it. And the first turnover of the game at a critical juncture, and the Eagles recover. And it was Darren Howard, the ex-Saint, who recovers for the Eagles, and they get the ball with 3:18 to go.
Watch them get up the field. They have this play defense well. Juqua Thomas is going to be there against Reggie Bush anyways. Let's see this pitch. He's got it right there. I don't know if Reggie Bush snuck a peek at number 75 because he knew that he was coming upfield, got his eyes off that ball, and it was on the ground.
First turnover of the game, and let's see whether the Eagles can capitalize on it. They have 2 timeouts remaining and a first down on their 44. And all the Eagles need is a field goal to tie it up. A touchdown will put them ahead. Garcia giving ground, and a dangerous screen pass, and it's caught by Westbrook, and Fred Thomas very nearly anticipated it, perfectly timed it and picked it off. It'll be a loss of 1, and the Eagles have to be holding their breaths here.
Well, they blitz both the linebackers. Brian Westbrook does a good job slowing him down. Jeff Garcia's got to float that ball up, gives Fred Thomas enough time to come in. I don't know whether he got confused or whether to go for the pick or put a big hit on Brian Westbrook.
Maybe a little of both. Second down and 11. L.J. Smith. Wide left. Buckholder to the right. The pitch going to Westbrook. And he is hit. Good play made after a 1-yard pickup by Scott Fujita. Second big defensive play he's made here in the second half. And that'll bring up third and long.
Where the Saints defense really stepped up on the last series. They were on the field, forced a three and out to get their offense back, trying to do the exact same thing here again after that turnover. Here's the matchup they've been looking for all night long. Dante Stallworth on Fred Thomas.
Third down and 10. Garcia flips it, unable to hold on as Westbrook. Garcia was going down. And it was Scott Fujita again putting the pressure on, and Garcia had to get rid of it in a hurry. And it'll be fourth down, but our two-minute warning. Let's bring you up to date on this close game. Stallworth on a 75-yard catch to give the Eagles a 7-6 lead. This was in the second quarter. Reggie Bush with a 4-yard run. The Saints were in front, 13-7. Westbrook giving the Eagles a 1-point lead at halftime. And then the big 62-yard run by Westbrook, an 8-point Philadelphia lead, the biggest by either team, and McAllister pushing determinedly, cutting the lead to 1, and then McAllister on an 11-yard pass play. Saints regain the lead, 27-21. Akers field goal cut it to 3. And here is our game summary, and a wild game as both McAllister and Bush have combined for 181 yards on the ground. Wild game here at the Superdome, Darryl.
Yeah, and look at all those all-time postseason records for each team. This game is exactly what we thought it was going to be, an offensive shootout. Great offenses on both teams.
Fourth down coming up. Fourth down and 10.
Well, it's definitely going to be another silent count because I can't even hear myself think down here. This stadium is rocking so hard.
So for the Eagles, their season could ride on this play. Garcia gets pressure, and the pass is caught, and picking up is Hank Baskin. And a flag back down at the 40-yard line. Penalty marker down.
There was no play. Before the snap, false start. We talked about it. The noise down here, it definitely affected them, and that's why they got the offsides on that play.
Can you believe that you handle the crowd noise the entire night? You get to a 4th and 10 with the season on the line. Scott Young inside flinches a little bit. The first time that you struggle with the crowd noise with a penalty on that play. What a great job by Jeff Garcia standing in there, delivering the ball to Hank Baskin.
Unbelievable by Jeff Garcia.
And the injury to Sean Andrews playing a big role in this game. Penalty on Young and the punt on fourth down and the fair catch called for by Reggie Bush. So the Saints have the ball in a 3-point lead. And if the Saints win and go on to the NFC Championship, they will have the lowest winning percentage in the season before of any team then advancing the following year to the conference championship game. And the Eagles have 2 timeouts remaining, 1:48 on the clock, and the Saints a first down on the 22.
The other thing we talked about, Tony, with this crowd noise going on, that silent count, no cadence. The other thing, Scott Young taking reps for Sean Andrews, who's out of the lineup. He hasn't had a lot of experience being with that group doing that.
First down. And here is McAllister. Deuce McAllister. And that's all the Saints want to do at this point. So the critical turnover, giving the Eagles an opportunity, but they could not take advantage of it. And the Eagles will call their second timeout. Want to remind you, the Seahawks and the Bears tomorrow. Not automatic for the Bears playing at home in January, as we've seen in recent years.
No, it is not automatic at all. And boy, if these Saints hold on and win this game, everybody in the city of New Orleans is going to be sitting in front of a TV. The Seattle Seahawks just will gain a whole legion of fans if the Saints hold on and pull this game out.
Sean Alexander, who missed the regular season game between those teams with a broken foot, will be back. In their last meeting, the Bears won handily, but that was ages ago. Philadelphia, one timeout remaining. It'll be second down and six. Here's McAllister. And McAllister, close to the first down, short by a yard. And now the Eagles will call their third and last timeout.
Watch the determination by Deuce McAllister on this run. I mean, this should be stopped for a two-yard gain. And look at him just bounce and work and push. He has run downhill behind his pads all night long.
How about that touchdown run? When he just pushed the pile all the way into the end zone when he went over from 5 yards out. So Deuce McAllister, after toiling and being hurt here in New Orleans for several years, finally in the playoffs. And the Saints are a minute 37 away from going to the conference championship game. 138 yards for Deuce McAllister on the ground today. Now the Saints will call a timeout.
New Orleans, they're first.
Now this is just a great effort by Deuce McAllister, because if you watch and see, I mean, right in there, he should be stopped at least at the 28. And he just keeps working, keeps pushing, gets it all the way out. They've got it marked at the 31-yard line. He gets them an extra 3 yards to get it to a third and short instead of a third and medium. Great effort by Deuce McAllister again.
Saints have rushed for 205 yards against the Eagles, and that had been a problem down the stretch for the Philadelphia defense. Not been able to handle the run as well as they have in previous years.
I just really feel that difference in the time from their last game. The Saints get the bye week. Sean Payton handles it very well. That first week, he lets them do some conditioning, some strength training, gets them on the field after he finds out who the opponent is. The Eagles, coming off that short week playing last Sunday, having to come back and play tonight. The one area that we've really seen it, I mean, you take away that 62-yard run by Brian Westbrook, and they really haven't really established the run tonight, where New Orleans has just been pounding it down the throat of the defense of the Eagles.
Still with all of that, the Eagles had a second down and one, and a chance to take the lead against the Saints. They had to settle for the field goal, and they never really got another solid chance. Third down and one. Here's McAllister. First down. The Eagles can't stop the clock. Gain of five. And Sean Payton. What a miraculous year for this franchise.
Just unbelievable what this team has been able to accomplish coming off that season last year. The way they've come together, new coach, new players, new systems to learn. And they come out and they have the type of season that they had this year.
And for the NFC South, the feather in their cap.
This city is electric right now, guys.
Tom Benson. This team did not play a home game last year. They were nomads. What would happen to the future of the Saints? Enter Payton and Brees and Reggie Bush and all the rest. And the New Orleans Saints are headed for the NFC Championship game next week on Fox. And the Philadelphia Eagles, who valiantly won six in a row to get to this point, will see their season end. Talk about finality.
That's the thing about the playoffs. Tony touched on it at the top. But the ironic thing about this, Sean Payton has a lot of respect for Andy Reid and what the Eagles have accomplished over the last 5 years. He wants his team to try and emulate what that run the Eagles went on did. He wants his Saints to do that. They took their first step tonight, the first NFC Championship game in franchise history. And who knows, maybe it'll be back here at the Superdome next weekend.
And McAllister with a season's high, 143 yards rushing. And so this playoff game ended with the exact same score as their regular season meeting, Saints 27, Eagles 24. And we'll be back at the Louisiana Superdome to wrap things up as the Saints defeat the Eagles and move on. Drew Brees, a touchdown pass. Deuce McAllister, a great game, 143 yards and a TD. And Dante Stallworth for the Eagles, three catches, 100 yards and a touchdown. UPS, what Brown can do for you. So this is Dick Stockton for Darryl Johnston and Tony Siragusa saying so long from New Orleans. Once again, the final score, Saints 27, Eagles 24. Stay tuned to Fox Sports for the AT&T Game Break Show with Kurt, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy right after these messages. Sean Payton weaves the magic for more. For more information on today's game and the latest NFL news, log on to foxsports.com. So long, everybody.
Yeah, it feels great. And this place is going nuts right now. Pandemonium. So we'll be watching tomorrow. We might end up getting an NFC Championship game here at home, but we'll see. But it was a great effort today. And what can I say? How about them Saints, huh?
Unbelievable. The offensive line did an unbelievable job of protecting it today. And really, you got to take your hat off to Deuce McAllister and the way he played running the ball.
All those guys played their hearts out, and really they have all season, and they're the main reason we're here. So you got to give it to them. Defense making that stand at the end, it was totally a team effort.
Thanks and congratulations. Thank man. You. Back to you guys.
All right, the fantastic story of the Saints season will continue next week. But Jimmy, a disappointing end for a Philadelphia team that really came a long way after Thanksgiving.
Kurt, 4th and 15 on your 39-yard line. You're going to punt the football. Well, you're banking on stopping them. Well, why not stop them on the 39? Because if you stop them, they have to punt. Even if you don't stop them, maybe it's a field goal. The bonus is you have a chance to make a first down on 4th and 15.
So you would have gone for it.
Gone for it.
Then you're only down by 6. And, you know, considering the way Philadelphia was playing defense, particularly in the second half and in the fourth quarter, New Orleans, their ability to pound the football at the end of the football game, controlling the clock for over 35 minutes. Great teams can run the football and stop the run when it counts.
Matchup tomorrow, either one of Seattle or Chicago Saints. I don't care if they're on the road or at home. I'm telling you, they can beat either one of those teams that they're going to watch tomorrow.
That diverse offense for the Saints paying off today. And once again, tomorrow, we'll find out who the Saints play in the NFC Championship game. It's the Seahawks at the Bears. Our coverage begins at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. Make sure we catch you there, folks. Congratulations once again to Sean Payton and the Saints. We'll see you tomorrow.
Nice job, Kurt.
That's it.
Promotional consideration paid for by